Hey there folks, this is GreenYaxi, welcoming you right back to Let's Play Alundra. This is episode 31. In last episode we made the start on Mt Torla, got to this point where we need to go up the left and right paths and solve a puzzle in each section in order to carry on with the dungeon. Like I said, not a short dungeon. Here are the last of the sort of ice pillar pushing puzzles. I hate them, but I mean, I say this one. There's the one on the opposite side as well, they both like it. Where should we start from? If we push down from there, it'll get stuck to there, so I'll end up there. If we pushed it across first, and then up, and then down. Left, it'll stop there, and then we could... If we do it left... If we did it left, down, right, up, that'll work. I think that's what we need to do. Right, okay. They're not too bad. They're not as hard as the ones in the ice mana, which is always a plus. Left, down. That's not gonna work actually. We pushed it up. Right, this'll do it.
There we go.
I can't push it across now. That was stupid. Okay, we'll have to go around again. Yeah, we did it. That was a nice easy one, wasn't it, really? So many ways of solving that one, I would say. Okay. Just light in the darkness, as I said, on the statue. Let's get these pots, try and find some health. I'm so skingy with my herbs and stuff. This is the harder one of the two. It's two of them you've got to push around using each other, making them bounce off each other. Okay. If we went right, and then pushed it up, we would be able to get that one. We went right and pushed it down, and then across. If we go too far, we won't be able to do it again. Let's try this. Let's just give it a go. That's the only way I can do these sorts of puzzles. Yeah, this has given us access to both of the bottom two, so that's good. Might have actually done it. I'm just shocked if that's the case. Right, I don't want to mess it up at the end now. If we go left... Yeah, we got it, we got it. Push this one left. Now we can push this one left. One by ya. Push it up. And there we go. Hey, we did it easy. I normally have a little bit of an issue with these puzzles. Nothing this time though. How amazing is that? There, done. You have no fear of the darkness. Receive the gift of our blessing. All this darkness stuff going on. Ooh, healing. All this darkness stuff going on reminds me of Golden Sun. I can't remember if it's the first one or the second, but you need to light the runes to carry on. I don't know. I can't remember which one it was. Not even which dungeon it was. I can't even remember the names of the dungeons in that game. I loved the first game when I was little. Dear God, I loved the first game. But... Ooh, we're at the end. We're at the end. I can't believe we made it to Mt Torla so easily. We never make it through this easily. And just the firebook. Really hard to miss. Where the hell we were meant to get a gilded falcon? I can't remember. But there we go. At least we made it through the dungeon. That's all that matters. Windbook, like I said in the last episode, will begin later on. We have now made it to the boss. No save point before it, but... If you've got... Hold on. This is Wilda. If you watched the opening cutscene, you would have seen this in the anime cutscene. You would have seen it there. Welcome, Elisa. I feel the warmth of the crest you already possess. I am Wilda, one of the seven. Once I was the king of destruction, once I was a god. I'm impressed that you have gathered 5 crests thus far. But until I am convinced of your true power, you will not gather the 6th. Challenge me, Elisa. Yeah, just 2 more to get. One of them we're going to be getting now. One of them we need to do another mini dungeon, I would say. Okay, I like to do Nava's charm. And the ice wand is what we need to kill her. Kill her. She has got a move which hurts you, even with the charm on, I seem to remember. But with the charm on, you can't get hurt by any of the fire attacks that she uses. I say she. Wilda reminds me of a female name. I think it is. I think it's meant to be a female dragon. Once the head comes down... Once the head comes down... Oh, not doing it again. Yeah, this is a long boss. We You just got it. Just got to prepare. She can. Yeah, there we go. Once she comes down. I normally put the Olga's ring on, but I don't think it affects the ice wand. I might be wrong, but I normally switch between Olga's ring and Nava's charm, you know, to get the most damage out. But like I said, I'm not sure if it even affects the ice wand. Ah, I can't move. You might as well charge it up as well. I'm sure it does more damage. Must do. Excuse me. My cult is pretty much gone now, by the way. It's just lingering about a little bit. That's all. Take that, you git. Doesn't look like a female dragon, but you can tell, really. I can't. Yeah, I don't know, there's not much more to say. You've seen everything it can do. I think it has. I think she might have one more attack with her sleeve. But we don't seem to be seeing it, so. I don't know what this attack is meant to be doing. Nothing. That's well. Nothing. Just making the screen go awkward. This is the start of the bosses, by the way, where they have a lot more health. A lot more health. And, you know you're coming towards the end of the game when that's happening, don't you? Are we done having a strop now? You're gonna drop your head? Nah. Don't feel like it. Walking on his own. Let's see where I end up. I'm sure maybe the water buff would be good. Use that 3 times and do a ton of damage maybe. Three times in one head drop. How good's that? Oh yeah, I was talking about the different games I could play on my new phone now. And I wanted to mention Final Fantasy Record Keeper as well. It's purely a nostalgia game, purely free to play. You can pay for more goals or something like that as well if you want, but who would do that? Unless you're really addicted, you know. But it's really good. It's like turn-based battles and you get to choose different characters between all the different Final Fantasy games. You have to collect them as you go through. But, you know, and it's still up. They're still updating the game, even now, a year later after it's come out, so I don't know if it's ever going to end. I played that for a bit. You have to have the internet to play that game, though. You know, literally, every time you want to play, you've got to have access to Wi-Fi. Oh, we're done! It always takes a while, that boss. Put Wilda on ice! Cheesy. Yeah! I love the little face he'd make when you beat a boss. And how he gets a sword out even if you never used it during the boss. Ooh, you humans have grown so strong, too strong, during my long rest. You may yet have the power to slay Melzus at last. I return to my sleep, Releaser. This time, for eternity.
No!
I shall honour my vow. Here, take this. Yeah! The 6th quest. We have one more to go. That one involves a mini dungeon out on the world map, so this is, like I was saying, that this is the last overworld dungeon except for the very last ultimate one, but there is another mini dungeon coming up as well. I will use the power I yet possess to return you to the world where humans yet live. Farewell, Releaser. Bye bye. I'm killing so many of the huge deities of the world, the huge creatures that are supposed to run this place. Hold on. Hold on. But, yeah, somehow. With permission of the dragon wielder, Alundra obtained the 6th crest. Only one more and Alundra would possess them all. But he was too preoccupied with other matters to realise it. He worried about Ronan. When would he break his silence and how? And what of the Murg? When would Melzus command them to attack? The night was quiet. A deafening silence closed in on Alundra. What does that mean for us? We'll do a bit more today. That'll be too short, surely. Alundra, wake up. We have a big problem. You awake? No! This is not the time for game, sleepyhead. This is serious. Okay. Burgess has been kidnapped by the Moog. We have to find him before. Hurry up, Alundra. Okay, actually, I am going to have to end it off here. If you just heard someone shouting up in the background. Grub's ready! And all that. So I better go. This has been GreenyXI. Thank you so much for watching this pretty short episode that finished off Mt Torla. I'll see you again in a bit when we check out where the hell Burgess has gone. And that's the twins, by the way, the twins of the village. The last nightmare is coming soon. See you in a bit, folks.